हेलो एवरीबॉडी, नमस्ते एंड सलाम अलैकुम। हाय, दिस इज मारिया खान, योर मास्टर टीचर ऑफ बायोलॉजी हियर एट वेदांतु। वेलकम टू माय सेशन गाइस, एंड टुडे आई हैव ब्रॉट एन अमेजिंग सेशन व्हिच इज गोइंग टू टेल यू फाइव प्रोडक्ट्स दैट आर जनरली फाउंड इन आवर हाउसहोल्ड्स व्हिच वी शुड स्टॉप यूजिंग इट नाउ। यस, सो टुडे द फोकस इज गोना बी ऑन सम फेमिनाइन प्रोडक्ट्स व्हिच यूजुअली योर मदर और योर सिस्टर्स और इवन यू आर यूजिंग इट। ओके, and I will be telling you why we should be stop using these products. Okay, so if you're curious to know about these products, hit on the like button, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to post me a you guys. Chalo, here we go. So the very first one on our list is intimate wash. Okay, so many a times we see n number of advertisements flashing on various channels, we get influenced by it and we end up purchasing it. Even doctors are pushing this kind of products to their patients, and these are sold under the name of intimate hygiene wash and so many other stuffs. So is it really good? And the second question is, do we really need these kind of products? So several researches have been conducted which actually say that the female vagina is a self-cleansing organ. Basically, it produces the chemical which is required to inhibit the growth of harmful microbes. Yes. So when it is a self-cleaning organ, why do we need an additional product? So washing your vagina just with plain water is more than enough. But no, we get influenced by these advertisements. Many a times the products are being sold under the tag of a herbal product or an Ayurvedic formulation. But many a times the ingredients are misleading. Basically, when we check out the composition, which we barely do, but still, all the herbal ingredients influence a lot. We feel, wow. It contains so many various herbs, but yes, fragrance. They don't tell us which chemical is used as a fragrance. And generally, these fragrances are really harmful to our health. Secondly, there are so many harmful chemicals, which are mostly not mentioned at all on the product bottle. Like if I tell you about the intimate hygiene product V-Wash, they put up all the list of ingredients on the carton. And if you see the product, they only mention that it is a lactic acid based formulation. Okay, so yes, when we use a product, we see lactic acid. It is the carton which we usually end up discarding it into the dustbin, right? So various researchers have actually stated that lactic acid, it actually inhibits the growth of harmful microbes. But what if I say this lactic acid is produced in the vagina naturally? Yes, so the vaginal eubiosis means the vaginal flora, that is the microbes that are present in a female vagina, okay, it already contains lactobacilli, and lactobacilli, it produces lactic acid. So yeah, when naturally lactic acid is being produced, we don't need a product which is a lactic acid based product, right? So what is the role that this lactic acid plays? Guys, lactic acid creates or generates a pH between 4 to 4.5, which creates unfavorable conditions for the growth of pathogens. Okay, and when it inhibits the growth of pathogens, it reduces the risk of bacterial vaginosis. It is as simple as that. So guys, lactobacillus, a bacteria which produces lactic acid, it generates a pH which inhibits the growth of pathogen. And it is as simple as that. So when naturally God has created a self-cleansing mechanism in our body, we don't need such products, right? So say goodbye to all these intimate hygiene products. Okay. So yeah, here is V-Wash. And besides lactic acid, there are so many various chemicals, right? So lauryl sulfate and fragrance and sorbitol, benzoic acid and phenoxyethanol and so many more. So yeah, please, we don't need all these chemicals. Lactic acid can serve the purpose and it is already naturally generated. So what experts actually recommend? One, for the hygiene of your private organs. One, prefer wearing cotton undergarments. Second, avoid wearing tight fitting clothes for longer durations. Okay. Then the third, it is not required to wash your vagina after every time you pee. It's not required. So if you're douching your vagina with water every now and then after you pee, stop doing that. Okay, that might trigger vaginal infection. And then follow proper sexual hygiene practice if you are sexually active. Okay, so these are the tips which are recommended by experts. Now, guys, there are several studies also, researches also, which are actually trying to evaluate the use of intravaginal douching products on the vaginal microbiota. Is it actually helping the growth of these microbes to flourish, or is it inhibiting their growth, or is it helping the vaginal infection to reduce, or it is actually introducing some vaginal infections? So yeah, there are several researches being conducted. Then the second product on my list is the body hair removal creams. So many a times the Bollywood actors are being hired, which are the brand ambassadors, and they tell us, lure us by saying 2 minutes or 3 minutes and you experience a smooth, flawless skin, and they say ki the skin becomes soft, it becomes smooth, and the hair are removed just in 3 minutes. So guys, have you ever wondered if a cream has the potential to dissolve your hair right in 3 minutes? So it must definitely contain some strong harmful chemicals which can actually not only affect your hair but even impact your skin in a negative manner, right? So even on these products, if you try to see the ingredients, they also come with a caution, and the caution is not suitable for head, face, eyes, nose, ears, anus, genitals, nipples, or any other body parts. So when it is sold as body hair removal cream, it is not meant for the usage all over your body. However, many people use it for removing the hair, maybe from the chest region or the armpits, pubic hair, and blah, 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 right? So yes, it is not recommended, not recommended. So underarms is very common area, it is suitable for underarms and bikini line, okay, legs and arms. But besides that, any other body part is not recommended where the product can be used. Okay, yep. And next, chemicals. If I talk about harmful chemicals which can dissolve your hair, so yeah, look at it. So many harmful chemicals. So why do we need? Embrace your body the way it is, guys. Again, it comes with another caution. Strictly not to be used beyond 6 minutes. If you use it beyond 6 minutes, it can have a negative impact on your skin. So now let us have a look at the safety index of various products which can be used for hair removal. So one, the hair removal creams. Usually the hair regrows back after 1 or 2 weeks, and the effect on your health can be really, really toxic. These chemicals can actually be absorbed in your skin. So do not ever use these products. Second, waxing. Much better, because it uproots your hair right from the follicles. Okay, and that's the reason why the hair grow back slowly. So it takes 3 to 4 weeks for the hair to regrow. And health aspect, it depends upon the wax. Okay, there are so many variety of wax that are available in the market. Then razors. So razors are the safest option, and within 1 to 2 weeks, your hair regrow back. And epilators, again, it takes 3 to 4 weeks and they are absolutely safe. So epilators are a bit costlier, but yes, they are safer, and health is wealth, right? So yeah, choose wisely. And then the third product on my list is the nail paints. Now, many people are so much addicted to nail paints, yeah? So many people have a range, collection of nail paints. Like, even we teachers are so much fascinated about nail paints. But do we really need them? So most of the nail paints contain harmful chemicals like dibutyl phthalate, toluene, and formaldehyde. There are several research papers which indicate that these chemicals, especially formaldehyde, are severely toxic. They have severe toxic impact on our health. Okay, so if I talk only and only about formaldehyde, it is a proven carcinogen. Yes, it is a cancer inducing agent. Okay, it can lead to dermatitis, that is inflammation of your skin. And besides that, there are several researches conducted where the chemical profile analysis of your blood was done before and after doing the manicure treatment, and it was found that harmful chemicals which were used for the manicure treatment, they were present in the bloodstream. Now, the research is not yet done to see ki whether the absorption of these chemicals, what is the rate of absorption of these chemicals, and is that much chemical more than enough to have a negative health impact on your body. So yeah, but if a chemical is absorbed into your bloodstream via nail paints or even by pedicure and manicure treatments, why do we need to go for it in the very first place, right? Scary, isn't it? Yes, it is. And once these chemicals are absorbed in sensitive people, the negative impact can be seen immediately within 10 to 15 minutes. So like, have you ever experienced like after applying the nail paints or after removal of the nail paints, the nails become dry, they become brittle, they become chapped? Have you ever felt that? If no, it's high time you start observing and studying the health of your nail. Okay, so what experts recommend? They recommend that nail paints must be applied only on special occasions. Okay, only on special occasions. And secondly, leave your nails without a paint few days every month. Why? Because underneath the coat of the nail paint, some bacteria begin to flourish, and that can actually have a negative impact. So do you want any infection of your nails or the cuticle or the skin around your nails? No, right? So please remove your nail paints occasionally, okay? Then apply one lighter coat instead of multiple coats. That's the third advice. And then the next product, health product, is the health drinks available in the market. Now, generally the products are being sold like exclusively for children, exclusively for women, exclusively for under 3 age, under 6 age, or under this, and blah 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 blah. So today here I'm going to talk about the women Horlicks or the health drinks which are actually meant for women. Okay, now if you carefully compare the ingredients of a normal health drink versus a health drink recommended for women, the ingredients are almost the same. And this is where the concept of pink tax comes into the picture. Means what? A product which is meant for females, and it is like not going to create any miraculous magic, but yes, just because it's meant for females and it is packed under a pink label or a pink wrapper or a pink packet, it is sold at a higher price, and the taxes are also on the higher side. Okay, and alternative, there are several alternatives. If I talk about the health drink for women health, okay, I'll recommend Shatavari powder. Okay, so there are so many formulations which include Shatavari, or you can go to an Ayurvedic shop, get Shatavari powder, Shatavari churna, add to milk, add honey, add kesar if you want, stir it and drink it. It's a best health drink. Okay, especially a lactating mother must consume Shatavari. If I talk about men, they can take Ashwagandha powder along with milk. That will equally serve the purpose. Ashwa means horse and gandh means fragrance. So the plant which actually has a fragrance of a horse, and it gives you a power just like a horse. Okay, so yeah, go for such products. Okay, and then the last product is deodorants. So guys, fragrances, everyone loves to smell good, right? But smelling good not at the cost of your health. So again, these body sprays, they again come with some harmful chemicals, but the most scariest ingredient of all is aluminium. So most of the times these products are aluminium based fragrance sprays. Okay, now why aluminium is a prime concern? Because aluminium is directly linked to neurotoxicity. It can affect your central nervous system or peripheral nervous system, or even both. It can even lead to Alzheimer's disease. In females, it's actually seen ki aluminium based sprays are directly linked to occurrence of breast cancer. It changes the gene behavior. It creates gene instability in the breast tissue, and thus it leads to breast cancer. So imagine applying a deo spray every morning after you take a bath, एंड वन फाइन डे गेटिंग डायग्नोस्ड विद ब्रेस्ट कैंसर, वर्स्ट नाइटमेयर, राइट? सो गाइस, इंस्टेड ऑफ लाइक यूजिंग ऑल दिस प्रोडक्ट्स, से गुड बाय ना. व्हाई डू वी डोंट नीड इट, राइट? एंड अदर इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू दिस डिओ स्प्रेस, वन, इट कैन लीड टू स्किन डार्कनिंग. चेक आउट द स्किन टोन ऑफ योर आर्मपिट, इट वुड हैव डेफिनेटली चेंज्ड बाय सेवरल शेड्स. इट कैन लीड टू इचिंग, हॉर्मोनल इम्बैलेंस, एलर्जी, वन कैन स्नीज एंड कॉफ. एटलीस्ट आई एम हाईली एलर्जिक टू डिओ स्प्रेस. सो या, से नो टू दिस आर्टिफिशियल फ्रेग्रेंसेस. एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एक्चुअली यूज एनी काइंड ऑफ फ्रेग्रेंस और डिओ स्प्रे, आई विल से गो फॉर अ हर्बल नेचुरल स्प्रे विच actually contains only and only herbal ingredients. It should include essential oils, no harmful chemicals, okay? So that is what is recommended. Achha. Coming to the last product on my list is the powder. So it can be any talcum powder or a compact powder or a baby powder or anything. So basically these powders are talcum based powder, talcs, right? Now use of talc is directly linked to lung disorders, lung issues, lung infections, and even ovarian cancer. So, have you ever like coughed or sneezed when anyone is powdering around you? So, that's the exact case. Ki this talc causes issue. So, yeah, it can lead to coughing, difficulty in breathing, decreased lung function, scarring of the lung tissue, and many more. It absorbs all the oil, it absorbs all the moisture from your skin, it makes your skin appear very dry, and it may even lead to acne outbreak. So yeah, is there any alternative? Yes, we have alternative. I actually used it for my son when he was like very tiny, and I used arrowroot powder, and I had also mixed one herbal powder. I don't remember, it was vetiveria powder if I'm not wrong, so that he doesn't contract cold that often. I don't remember exactly the herb, but yes, I had used. So arrowroot powder, use it as a base, then add cocoa powder depending on your skin tone, ki how lighter shade or a darker shade that you want. And then us Indian skin tone, it has a tinge of brownish and a yellowish shade, so add a bit turmeric also, mix it well, and tada, here your natural homemade face powder is ready. Okay, so yes guys, use it. It's absolutely safe for your skin, for babies, for adults, for old age people. Anyone and everyone in your house can use it, and it's cheaper and it's good for your health, right? So yeah, that's it for the day guys. If you really love the session, like, share, subscribe, post me a you, and the link has been given in the description box. If you are willing to enroll with Vedantu, okay, and if you're visiting the link, ensure that my coupon code is applied, that is MACPRO, okay, which is going to give you 10% additional discount. So yeah, that's it for the day guys. Let's meet up in the next session. Till then, Allah Hafiz, Allah Hafiz, and keep watching Vedantu. Bye bye. Thank you so much.